Integrating the subjective and objective perspectives of time is a deep and complex endeavor. It requires untangling the relationship between our personal experience of time and the physical, objective passage of time. This synthesis is particularly interesting when examined through Roger Penrose's quantum theory of consciousness, which draws on cosmology, quantum mechanics, and the role of timelessness within subjective consciousness. Penrose proposes that consciousness can uniquely access timelessness through the process of subjective insight. This idea exploits the peculiarities of quantum mechanics and cosmology, where timelessness manifests itself in phenomena such as wave function, collapse, and closed time-like loops. To advance this theory, a fractal model of time is proposed that can link infinity to finitude, and thus timelessness to time. Penrose's argument goes back to the idea that human consciousness uses an incalculable physical mechanism to access Plato's timeless realm of ideas. This leads to the search for an incalculable process in nature that consciousness can uniquely use. In this framework, Penrose explores the non-computability of the brain using models and concepts in objective reduction theory, such as the Mandelbrot set and the collapse of quantum superposition. Another intriguing possibility for non-computability is offered through the concept of closed time-like loops. When we delve into the biological substructure of consciousness, specifically the cytoskeleton of neurons, microtubules emerge as a candidate for additional computational power beyond neural firing. Microtubules, composed of tubulin proteins arranged in 13 columns, transmit information through their dynamic, oscillatory activity. This process may underlie a form of computation that is crucial to consciousness. The structural dynamics of tubulin proteins are crucial. These proteins can change shape like muscle proteins, but their role in the brain is less clear. Tubulin's ability to undergo conformational changes is regulated by hydrophobic pockets inside the proteins that operate through dipole couplings or van der Waals forces, particularly London dispersion forces. These forces govern protein folding and conformation, processes that are essential for microtubule function. Anesthetics interact with these hydrophobic pockets, disrupting protein shape-shifting and thus microtubule activity. This intervention is associated with loss of consciousness under anesthesia, suggesting that protein dynamics are an integral part of conscious experience. Conversely, psychedelics increase protein activity and electron mobility, potentially increasing the possibility of quantum superposition within microtubules, which could explain their ability to alter consciousness. This means that proteins are deeply involved in the physical correlates of consciousness through their complex dynamic behavior. The modulation of protein activity by anesthetics and psychedelics highlights the link between molecular processes and conscious experience. Stuart Hameroff's contributions to this field, particularly his research on microtubules and consciousness, are respected, if speculative. This interdisciplinary approach is likely to bridge the gap between subjective experience and objective reality by enriching our understanding of how consciousness can emerge from complex physical processes. Examining consciousness through the lens of protein translation offers a compelling analogy to computational systems, particularly in the context of tubulin dynamics. Tubulin, a key protein in the microtubules of neurons, undergoes conformational changes that can be likened to the binary operations of bits in classical computers. Tubulin switches between two different conformations that mirror the binary states of 0 and 1 in digital computation. However, this analogy raises an important question. Is the computational paradigm sufficient to fully explain the brain's capabilities? Traditional computation operates at a rate of about 10 to the power of 8 operations per second, and the most advanced systems reach about 10 to the power of 14 operations per second. In contrast, the human brain, with 10 to the power of 11 neurons and an average of 10 to the power of 4 synapses per neuron, operates at a very different scale. If each synapse can change state every millisecond, the brain can reach a rate of 10 to the power of 18 operations per second. Furthermore, if we consider the hypothesis that tubulin is a computational element, with 10 to the power of 7 tubulin molecules per neuron, switching 10 to the power of 9 times per second, the brain's computational power could approach 10 to the power of 27 operations per second, greatly exceeding current artificial systems. Despite this astonishing potential, a fundamental problem with relying solely on computational models to explain consciousness remains. In his seminal work, The Emperor's New Mind, 1989, Roger Penrose argues that the human mind operates beyond the limits of classical computation. He uses the Turing-Halting problem and Gödel's incompleteness theorems to illustrate this point. In particular, Gödel's theorem shows that within any formal system, there are true propositions that cannot be proven within the system itself. This means that human cognition can grasp truths that are inherently non-computational. Penrose suggests that consciousness uses non-computational processes, which he associates with spontaneous insights that transcend algorithmic computation. This raises a profound question. How does the brain, a time-bound physical system, facilitate contact with timelessness through consciousness? Penrose's concept of insight as a bridge between the temporal and the timeless raises a paradox that challenges conventional wisdom. He suggests that this relationship can be explained in terms of mathematical structures that exhibit non-computability. Two such structures are the Mandelbrot set and the phenomenon of quantum superposition collapse. The Mandelbrot set, a well-known fractal, exemplifies the concept of non-computability, characterized by their self-similarity and infinite complexity. Fractals overlap with the concept of bridging the finite and infinite, the temporal and the timeless. In this context, the fractal model of time may offer a new framework for understanding how consciousness interacts with timelessness. With their inherent repetitive and self-similar properties, fractals provide a mathematical basis for relating finite temporal experiences to the infinite, timeless realm. This model is consistent with the idea that insights emerge from a deeper, timeless structure and manifest in our temporal consciousness. Penrose's research in quantum mechanics further supports the role of non-computability in consciousness. The collapse of quantum superposition, a process in which a quantum system transitions from multiple possible states to a single definitive state, exemplifies an uncomputable event. This quantum reduction, as theorized by Penrose, may underlie non-algorithmic processes that facilitate consciousness. The complex relationship between time, timelessness, and consciousness thus remains a deep and enigmatic frontier in theoretical physics. Roger Penrose's discovery of non-computability in mathematics, particularly through non-recursive sets, offers a profound insight into the physical foundations of consciousness. Penrose moves on to recursive sets by emphasizing that although an algorithm can produce such a set of numbers, it cannot produce the complement of the set. This complement represents the non-computability that intrigued Penrose in his search for the non-computational basis of consciousness. A particular focus of this discovery is the Mandelbrot set, a fractal set with important implications for this discussion. The Mandelbrot set is defined in the complex plane, where recursive squaring and addition operations are performed. If the result exceeds a certain limit after a finite number of iterations, the point is considered unbounded and is colored. If it remains within this limit indefinitely, it is part of the Mandelbrot set and is colored black. The colored areas, therefore, represent the complement of the Mandelbrot set. The infinite complexity of the boundary of the Mandelbrot set where the points continually reveal new layers of detail upon magnification, demonstrates its incomputability. No algorithm can precisely determine the fate of every point after infinite iteration, making the Mandelbrot set itself incomputable. Ignoring the boundary simplifies the problem and somehow misses the essence of fractals, where the infinite complexity of the boundary is fundamental. The Mandelbrot set metaphor is based on a broader convention that interweaves the bounded and boundless regions, paralleling the duality of time and timelessness in the study of consciousness. This concept is expanded by Morin's dialogic concept, in which binary logics or categories remain complementary yet opposing. This dialogic nature reflects the role of the fractal model in demonstrating the complexity and interdependence of time and timelessness. At this point, it is necessary to go even deeper into the physical realm and emphasize the intrinsic nature of the brain's non-computational processes in the fundamental actions of inanimate matter. This takes us beyond neurobiology and chemistry to the fundamental interactions of space-time, quantum mechanics, and general relativity. The unique organization of the mind allows it to use non-computational processes in physical laws that distinguish it from ordinary materials. Penrose's hypothesis for this is that consciousness emerges from these deep physical principles, perhaps through the orchestrated collapse of quantum superpositions, a process he calls objective reduction. This collapse can be affected by the geometry of space-time and can connect the macroscopic and quantum realms in a way that is beyond the reach of classical computation. The implications of this theory are profound. It suggests that consciousness is not an emergent property of complex computations within neural networks, but is fundamentally connected to non-computational aspects of the universe. This perspective is consistent with the idea that human cognition can tap into realities beyond algorithmic boundaries, tapping into a timeless realm of ideas. Ultimately, Penrose's exploration of non-computability via the Mandelbrot set and his extension of these concepts to quantum mechanics and general relativity provide a compelling framework for understanding consciousness. Thanks for listening, and take care.